Hello friends, in this video I will tell you about the time zone and offset classes in the new date and time API of Java, Java SDK that is. Time zone and offset. The time zone, what is a time zone? It is a region on the earth where a particular standard time is used. For example, IST, the time zone IST is used in India. So, to standardize the time in a particular zone, in a particular region on the earth, the time zones are marked out. Each time zone is described by an identifier. Usually, the identifier contains the name, the region or city like this. For example, Asia Tokyo or Asia Kolkata, like that. And an offset from the Greenwich Mean Time or UTC time. For example, the Indian Standard Time is having an offset 5 hours 30 minutes from the GMT. For example, exactly the Tokyo time is having an offset of plus 9 hours. Zone ID class specifies the time zone identifier and provides the rules for converting them between the instant and local date time. So, for the conversion purpose, this zone ID class can be used, conversion between the instant and the local date time. Zone offset class, on the other hand, specifies the time zone offset from GMT and UTC. These are the two classes that are present. Zone ID class. The zone ID class specifies the time zone identifier and provides a rule for converting between the instant and local date class. It inherits the object class and implements the serializable interface. How to obtain the object? Zone ID. The object name is also zone ID, but this is in upper case, this is in lower case, is equal to zone ID dot now. Okay, so this is the standard method of creating a zone ID object. You can also create the zone ID by providing zone ID dot off the offset, and you can also create the zone ID dot off by giving the identifier, either by giving the ID or by giving the identifier. Both ways you can create a zone ID. Now we'll create the, or rather fetch the zone ID of the time that is present in the system clock. Zone ID class methods. Display name, for example, IST is represented by, or IST is corresponding to Asia / Calcutta. That display name or the textual representation will be written by the get display name. Get ID will return the unique time zone ID. Zone ID of a particular string zone ID. It is used to obtain an instance of zone ID from the ID. System default will give you, it is used to get the system default time zone. Whether it is equals to or not, it is used to check if the time zone ID is equal to the another time zone, to compare two IDs. These are the functions or methods available in the zone ID class. Then there is a zone offset class. It is used to represent the fixed time zone offset between the current time zone or your time zone and the GMT or UTC. As you will expect, this offset class inherits the zone ID class and it also implements the comparable interface. Zone offset class declares three constants: max, min and UTC. Max is the maximum supported zone offsets, min is the minimum supported offsets, UTC is the current time zone offset. Okay, so depending using these, the zone offset class can be defined. What are the functions associated with the zone offset? Adjust into. It is used to adjust the specified temporal object to have the same offset. Get gets the value of a specified field. Is supported. It is used to check if the supported field is available or it can be used or not. Off, we have used this, is used to obtain the instance of zone offset from the ID. Off hours, used to obtain the instance of zone offset using an offset in hours, that also we have used. Of hours minutes, obtain the instance of zone offset using offset in both hours and minutes. And range, used to get the range of valid values. These are all the methods available to the zone offset class, zone ID class and zone offset class. So, the functionality of both these classes we shall put into actual use in an example. I will show you an example, execute the example and explain the use of all these methods practically by running the example. So, the example is in front of you.
Let us now see the functionality of the zone offset class. For this purpose, I am first creating an object of the zone offset class, zone offset zone is equal to using the dot UTC defined constant. And then I am trying to return a temporal object by adjusting this offset zone so that the zone date time dot now is adjusted into the temporal object. So if you print it out, you will see the information of this zone date time object converted into a temporal object. This is the first activity. Secondly, I create two objects of zone offset Z and O. In order to create Z object, I call the method zone offset dot off hours 5. So offset of 5 hours will be created. If I print it out, it will print the offset value. Similarly, I create an object O of the zone offset class by calling the dot off method and giving the string representation of the offset that I want. I am giving it as -8.00, so that means negative 8 hours. Okay, and then I have a local date time object D is equal to, I am providing the arguments like year, month, date, hours and minutes. So there is a local date time object D and then there is an offset object O. Combining these two, I can create an object of offset date time. It will require two arguments, D and O. D is the local date time and O is the offset. So you will find that OD will be the offset date time by using the offset O. I can use the offset Z also for creation of the offset date time object. So these are some of the methods or functionality associated with the zone offset class. We'll compile this and run to see the result. Okay. There you go. This is the temporal representation of the zone date time object. This is the first offset that I have created of hours 5. The offset date time using -8 as the offset and the +5 as the offset. These are the outputs of our different activities. Okay. So that is our zone offset class behavior.